Next, we'll have a look at the storage class, which applies to objects and function parameters. It has some impact on the visibility of functions, and we know that every data object and parameter that we use in a program must have a storage class, so it must somewhere be stored in memory, basically. Okay, either we can tell him the storage class, our compiler the storage class, or it is set by default, which is what we used so far. This is similar to using the auto storage class, okay? So, the object storage class determines the availability to the linker as well and its lifetime. There are four storage classes, the auto, which is our default, basically for local objects mostly. We can store data in the registers, which means the CPU register. We can store it as extern, that means it is somewhere in memory, but we don't declare yet where it is. And we can say it's static, which means it's basically default for global objects. It lives in memory and during the whole runtime of my application. So automatic, well, that's basically what we used for local variables a lot already. It means after the stack frame is removed, the variable gets removed from the stack. The object is not initialized by default. Well, it's really optional to call it auto, and I would not advise you to do it. Just if you see it, basically it is about local variables. Okay? Then we talk about static. Static objects are not available to the linker. So that means you can have different compilation units that have this identical identifier or symbol. And the static class specifies that space for the identifier is maintained for the whole duration of our program execution. That means there is a memory location somewhere typically below our stack where the memory is allocated, and this memory region is used the whole time during our program, and you can always access this object. Right, so we learned that we can use it inside a function, and that means the value is still kept after the function ends. Right, if a data object is declared outside of a function, well, it has static duration by default. Then we had extern. Extern storage class objects have the same storage duration as static, but they are visible to the linker for external linkage. It is the default class for objects within our file scope, so global variables functions. And that means those can be used in our linker for different compilation units. So it's really useful to share across compilation units. I use it extern typically only for global variables, like I said before. Lastly, we have register variables. So we remember that the CPU has a set of storage registers and a cache, and from main memory you have to pull basically the data into the cache and then to the registers to manipulate the data. And a register keyword tries to keep an object in the register. The compiler may not grant the wish though, so it may be not possible to do that because the number of registers is limited. You can use this for local variables, and you can specify this for a function parameter to keep it in a register. Well, this was useful in the past because the caches were particularly inefficient and memory was so much slower. Therefore, it was quite useful to keep, for performance reasons, some variables, like for example, the variable I. If you run a for loop and iterate over, you know, I, then might be useful to keep it in a register for performance reasons. So it's still useful in some embedded devices, but not generally. So how you use that? Well, we have a function and we have a variable R of type integer. Well, we say it should be placed in register. Also here we can use it in a local, in our local block, and can have our local variable heavy that should be stored in a register.